Hello, welcome back to Synapse. In an earlier demo, Marcy explained how hardware and gizmos form the signal path for Synapse experiments. In this demo, we'll build on that knowledge, as I show you how to build your own experiment using gizmos. Okay. Let's jump right in. This experiment will collect and record neural data using a PZ5 bioamp. That means the PZ5 will be the start of the processing or signal path. Gizmos that can be added to this device are displayed in the gizmo list. PZ5 hardware options are displayed to the right. But wait. In another demo, you learned that hardware is configured in the rig. That's true. The rig stores universal information about your hardware system, used by all experiments. Options modified here are saved with this experiment, but won't be carried over to other experiments. Before we add gizmos, we need to modify a few of these experiment-specific settings. The PZ5 is a multimodal device. It can record different kinds of signals on independent logical amplifiers, defined here. Let's give it a try. The first logical subamp, sub 1, is already set up for recording 16 channels of single unit data. This is perfect for 16-channel tetrode array recordings. On sub 2, I'll be recording 4 channels of LFPs from a different electrode array in my subject. I'll use the PZ5's built-in signal conditioning for this type of recording by changing the base type to LFP. Now that the PZ5 is configured, it's time to add the gizmos. There are gizmos for many different tasks. I'll start with the LFP filtering gizmo from the neural group. Synapse displayed the block diagram for this gizmo. That means wait. Take a step back and think about this. Synapse found more than one possible input source, and I need to specify which one. The two logical subamps configured earlier are listed under PZN1 as possible input sources. I'll need to select AMP2 for the LFPs. The diagram also provides a simple visual depiction of how the gizmo works. This gizmo includes its own filter and data storage. We can also see the data type for each input and output. This aqua icon means the gizmo expects a floating point input, which is exactly what the PZ5 provides. There are a number of data types, including green for logic signals, pink lavender for parameters, blue for integers, and white for inputs that can accept any data type. The diagram often includes additional information next to the input or output, such as number of channels, and allows you to apply offsets to select the correct channel numbers. The gizmo has been added to the processing tree beneath the PZ5 amplifier, and its settings are displayed to the right. We see no gizmos in the gizmo list because the LFP gizmo is now selected in the processing tree. The input and output data types are also used to populate the gizmo list with compatible gizmos. However, I didn't enable the LFP's gizmo's optional output, so no gizmos can be added here. To find the gizmo for tetrode sorting, I must select the source of the tetrode data, the PZ5. The tetrode gizmo is now available. The last gizmo needed for this experiment is a mapper. This gizmo is used to reorganize the data channels from the amplifier into their proper tetrode configuration. With that configured, let's take a look at the processing tree. Uh-oh. This is bad. Very bad. Because the tetrode gizmo was selected when I added the mapper was added beneath, or after, the tetrode. Now, I'll have to back up. The gizmo needs to be added between the amplifier and the tetrode gizmo so that the channels are reorganized before sorting. To fix this, I'll display the mapper block diagram. Just like before, I can select the input source and commit the change. This repositioned the mapper gizmo in the signal path. Now I can do the same thing in the tetrode block diagram or I can drag the tetrode sorter to a position after the mapper. I'm feeling lazy, so I'll pick the easier one. Voila! The experiment is now configured and ready to run. The tetrode spike sorting gizmo, used in this experiment, includes a fabulous runtime sorting interface, but we've run a little long, so I'll show you how to use it in a separate demo. Bye for now.